Now at 6:30 this week, President-elect Joe Biden will be sworn in as the 46th President of the United States. Although because of the pandemic and threats to the Capitol, the inauguration of President-elect Biden will be scaled down and security will be beefed up. CBS News correspondent Bafta Yameem is in Washington with the latest.
Just over 2 days from the presidential inauguration, the nation's capital is on lockdown, encircled by high fences, barbed wire, and heavily armed troops. The New Yorker magazine published chilling, high-resolution video of the insurrection at the U.S. Capitol by supporters of President Trump over a week ago. Scott Pelley of CBS's 60 Minutes asked D.C. Mayor Muriel Bowser about the decision to give combat weapons to National Guard members providing inauguration security.
Are you glad about that, or are you worried about it?
It's a place in our history that I'm sad that we've come to. American troops should not have to be armed against their fellow Americans. But what we saw was an unprecedented attack on our democracy and the cradle of that democracy.
A new CBS News poll finds more than 70% of Americans feel U.S. democracy is threatened. Protesters turned up at the State House in Columbus, Ohio, Sunday. In Lansing, Michigan, armored trucks took position with a number of demonstrators on hand.
Here in Washington, law enforcement remains on high alert with elevated threat levels, especially around areas near the Capitol building.
Across the U.S., federal and local investigators are making daily arrests of those accused of storming the Capitol building. Authorities say this man, Edward Jacob Lange, pointed himself out in photos of the riot on social media and was arrested in New York. In Nashville, these three allegedly involved in the Capitol invasion were brought into custody. More than a third of governors have called out the National Guard to help protect their state capitals and aid local law enforcement officers. Bofta Imam, CBS News, Washington.